put us on in great competition with other cities along the East Coast, and I'm excited about the possibilities.
A transformation at the Inner Harbor could take Baltimore to the next level. The Greater Baltimore Committee wants to build a new arena, a bigger convention center, and a new hotel downtown.
The rest of the revitalization would also include a facelift for the Inner Harbor. 11 News reporter Sheldon Dutez is live in Federal Hill. He has more on this for us. Sheldon?
Well, Rod, part of that revitalization will include a laser light show that would light up the Inner Harbor on nights like this one. Now, Mayor Rawlings-Blake says she likes a lot of these ideas, but she seems to see the results of a feasibility study before she can make a final decision. This artist's rendering shows us what downtown Baltimore's future skyline could look like. The Greater Baltimore Committee wants to transform this area around the Conway Street Sheraton Hotel into a new arena, bigger convention center, and a new 500-room hotel.
This would be a hybrid building that really wouldn't exist anywhere else in the United States on this kind of level.
Also part of the revitalization, nighttime laser shows over the harbor, and a facelift for Rash feel comparable to waterfront parks in Seattle and New York.
I think it'd be great. I mean, coming here for concerts, you know, sports, things like that, I think it'd be great. And you can walk here, you got the light rail and everything like that. I think it'd be, you know, tremendous.
What makes this a very viable project is the amount of private sector investment that would be a part of this plan.
Baltimore businessman Williard Hackerman says he'll contribute $500 million toward the project. The remaining $400 million would have to be funded publicly.
The first thing is to see the economic feasibility and to study the market. And after we study the market, that's when you can make a determination of whether or not it's a sound investment.
Locals like Colin Cronin are excited for the arena's potential to attract another pro sports team.
The Baltimore Bullets were here years ago, and a lot of my friends who were fans upset that they went down to Washington, D.C., so they'd love to and would welcome them back, so I think it would be great.
A lot of people in Baltimore and the region that are hoping that, so we'll just stay tuned. We'll see. One step at a time. I miss having a basketball team here in Baltimore, and I know that I would make a lot of people very happy if we could get that done.
The Stadium Authority is expected to release the findings of its economic feasibility study by the end of the year. We're live tonight in Federal Hill. Sheldon Dutez, WBAL-TV 11 News.